Testament scripture this morning is from Matthew 22:34-46. When the Pharisees heard that he had silenced the Sadducees, they gathered together, and one of them, a lawyer, asked him, "Teacher, which is the greatest commandment? Which commandment in the law is the greatest?" Jesus said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the greatest and the first. And the second commandment is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets." Please join me in prayer. Holy God, we ask that you be with us now, that you silence every voice within us but your own, and you startle us with your truth. Amen. I was at a conference this week, and for church nerds, it was super exciting because we had classes like Advent church that came out of divorce because Henry VIII wanted to divorce his wife. But the Pope, the Catholic Church said no. And so he became involved in the Reformation, but just giving a nod to my Episcopalian friends, that is not the sole reason why the Reformation happened in England with the Anglicans. There were more things going on, or people involved, kind of like what Martin Luther was doing. So it was really a time of just shaking up the church all over the place. Just shaking it up. And then what began to happen was the Protestants began to just get really mad because they wanted things to be different or wanted to have their own worship space, that sort of thing. And then the Catholics got upset too. And what happens when two groups of people get really upset over religion?
Ireland.
That is correct. Very creative. Yes. So Ireland is mainly Catholic, and there was a big dispute. At one point, it was the Protestants kind of ruled that, and. Maybe there won't be denominations anymore because a lot of people don't necessarily look for a particular denomination. They look for a place where they will fit. She said a lot of stuff that made regular church people super uncomfortable, but it was good. And they also talked about in this book how there might be some people who would be still attached to their tradition, the good things in their tradition, but would want something to make it even more relevant and up to date.
society in general, whether there aren't as many people going to sponsored churches as there were before. They're looking for a relationship with God and with the people that, that they want to worship.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, society's really changed, right? There are a lot of people who will say I'm spiritual but not religious, which usually means I can be spiritual by myself and not go to church. Generally, as Christians, we say that you need both. It's being spiritual and being with God, but you also need to be part of a community to encourage you, provide accountability, break being with other people. What other ways does anybody feel like the church is being shook up? Against that particular time. the Reformation and the different people. Like, there's this one where Zwingli, who was the one who was like, no baptism of kids, and communion isn't really a sacrament, it's an ordinance, and then Martin Luther punches him. Which, you know, Martin Luther, I would like to meet him and figure out, were you that angry before it started, just in general, or did this whole mess